Hello students, welcome back for the history class. We are doing third chapter, an empire across the three continents, and in this we are going to talk about the second last topic of this chapter, that is the social hierarchies. Okay, so before we begin with this topic, we have talked about the slaves and the labor conditions, that are the worker conditions, in my previous video. So somewhere the workers and the laborers were the part of the society. So in this video we will be talking about the social structure or the social pattern, social distribution was how it was done. So let's start the discussions on this. So when we talk about the social structure of this empire, there is a person who is talking about this social groups. He is Tacitus. He is giving us an example, explanation from the earlier empire. The society was divided into three sections. First one was the senates, second one was the equites, and the third one is considered as a lower class. Okay, so when we talk about the senators are considered as the fathers or the leading members of the equestrian class. They are respectable sections of the people, those attached to the great houses. Okay, they are the wealthiest person. And moreover, they are also named as a mantri of the kings. The unkept lower class means the lower class is a different one who is considered as the different sections of the society. Now he also tell us that the finals were the slaves. They are considered from the lower classes. So in the third century, when the senates number were around, senates were the people who were considered as the fathers. So when we talk about the senates, their number were roughly 1,000, and among these thousands, half of the senators, they only came from the Italian families. So that shows ki how much the Italian dominance was there of senators. So the senators 50% populations were considered from the Italian families. But by the late empire, which starts with the regime of the Constantine, it's a new ruler who has begun his empire or regime in the late empire, that is around the 5th to 6th century. Okay, so earlier part of is the 4th century, the first two groups mentioned by Tetrarchs means from the first were the senators and second were the equites. So we have talked about the senators, let's talk about the equites, equites. So these equites, who are these equites? These equites are the knights or the horsemen, which were traditionally the second most powerful and wealthiest group of the society, and they were originally the family who were the having the property 50 means property who with their qualified them to serve as a cavalry. Hence the name like senators. Most knights were landlords, land owners, but unlike senators, many of them were ship owners, traders and bankers, that is involved in business activities. Okay, so these equities were considered from the second class, and they were also from the wealthiest group of the society. Okay, so with their horsemen and the knights, they belonged from the military elites, and later on they had a society which was belonged from the aristocracies. ठीक है, and in late the third section of the society were considered as a middle class, and now they are consisted of a mass of persons which are belonged from the imperial services like the bureaucrats and the army. So even the most prosperous merchants and the farmers were also belonged from the middle class. So we can say middle class were the people from the late century were working as a bureaucrats. Bureaucrats means the staff officials of the emperors. So they were considered as most respectable persons, and they as the clients of the great senatorial houses. So now it is chiefly government service and dependent on the state that sustained many of their families. Correct. So this middle class emerged in the late empire, late Roman Empire के time पे ये third middle class family generate हुई थी. ठीक है. So when we talk about the third, they are the lower classes, and they were from the vast masses of the population, and they were collectively known as the humerales, and that is the lower class. So they compared from the ruler labor forces, okay, which many were permanently employed in the large estates. Even they were the workers in the industries and the minings, and even they were the migrant workers who supplied much of the labor for the grain or olive harvest and for the building industries. So this all self-employed artisans and the merchants, industrial workers, mining workers. So these all are, even the wages laborers, the large masses of the casual laborers, they all belonged from the lower classes, especially in the big cities. And of course, many thousands of the slaves that were still found all over the western part of the empire were belonged from the lower categories. Correct. I hope you understood. जो भी हमारी social structure है वो early empire में a little difference है, और जो late empire में difference है, late Roman period में थोड़ा सा difference है, just कि यहाँ पे middle class emerge हो गया था, वहाँ पे middle class नहीं था. ठीक है. So the next paragraph is talking about the one writer who was belonged from the 5th century. He is an historian and as well as an ambassador. He tells about the aristocracies group. Kaun sa wala group? Jisko bureaucrats yani middle class bola gaya hai, jo grew ho gaya tha Roman Empire mein, aur they were drawing annual income up to 40,000 blips of gold. यानी उनकी जो इनकम थी वो इतनी ज्यादा हो गई थी कि वो अपने आप में एक गोल्ड एनुअल इनकम लेते थे, और फ्रॉम द स्टेट्स. ठीक है ना. एंड दे नॉट काउंटिंग द प्रोडक्ट्स दे कंज्यूम्ड डायरेक्टली, उनके अलावा भी वो चीजें बहुत डायरेक्टली कंज्यूम करते थे. सो ये कुछ है सोसाइटी जिन्होंने मिडिल क्लास को काफी अपने राइटिंग्स में लिखा है. सो वी ऑल्सो सी दैट कि ये जो गोल्ड कॉइन्स जब उनको एज अ एनुअल इनकम मिलता था, तो मॉनेटरी सिस्टम ऑफ द लेट एम्पायर ब्रोक. with the silver based currency. So gold was changed into the silver based currency of the first 3 centuries, because the Spanish silver mines were exhausted and government ran off of sufficient stock of the metals to support a stable coinage in silver. ठीक है ना. सो ये जो स्पेनिश सिल्वर माइन है, इसके खत्म होते ही गवर्नमेंट ने डिसीजन लिया कि जो सिल्वर कॉइन्स होता था वो अब बन जाएगा, सॉरी गोल्ड कॉइन था वो अब सिल्वर कॉइन में बन जाएगा. तो कॉन्स्टाइन ही वॉज अ रूलर. ही हैज फाउंडेड द न्यू मॉनिटरी सिस्टम ऑन गोल्ड एंड देयर वॉज अ वास्ट अमाउंट ऑफ दिस एंड सर्कुलेशन थ्रू आउट द लेट एंटिकी. तो ये कॉन्स्टाइन ने इसको लेट एंटिक्विटी तक संभाल के रखा था. सो द लेट रोमन जो ब्यूरोक्रेट्स थे, दे बिलोंग्ड फ्रॉम द हायर एंड द मिडिल ग्रुप्स एंड दे वर कंपैरेटिवली द इन्फ्लुएंस्ड ग्रुप्स बिकॉज दे ड्रू सैलरीज इन द बल्क इन द गोल्ड एंड इन्वेस्टेड मच ऑफ दिस इन बाइंग अप स्टेट्स लाइक लैंड. इन्होंने बहुत सारा पैसा जो मिडिल क्लास ग्रुप जो एमर्ज हुआ था लेट रोमन पीरियड में, स्पेशली द ब्यूरोक्रेट्स, दे हैव इन्वेस्टेड देयर मनी देयर सैलरी ऑन बाइंग द लैंड. ठीक है. देयर वॉज ऑफकोर्स ऑल्सो अ ग्रेट डील ऑफ करप्शंस. इन्होंने अपने समय पे यानी ब्यूरोक्रेट्स ने करप्शंस भी किया था. तो इसको कंट्रोल करने के लिए दे हैव स्टार्टेड अ ज्यूडिशियरी सिस्टम एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ मिलिट्री सप्लाईज. ठीक है ना. सो गवर्नमेंट ने इसको अपने अंडर में लिया और ज्यूडिशियरी सिस्टम भी रखा था. तो द हायर ब्यूरोक्रेट्स एंड द ग्रीड जो इनका था दैट वॉज प्रोबेबल, यानी वो उनके अकॉर्डिंग वो सही थे, बट गवर्नमेंट इंटरवेंट रिपीटेडली टू क्रब दीज फॉर्म ऑफ करप्शन. इसको स्टॉप करने के लिए गवर्नमेंट ने बार बार इसको इंटरप्ट किया. वी ओनली नो अबाउट दैम इन द फर्स्ट प्लेस बिकॉज द लॉज आर ट्राई टू पुट दैम एंड पुट एन एंड टू दैम एज वी हैव टॉक्ड इन द वर्कर्स वीडियो ऑल्सो. कि जो लॉ बनाया था द लॉ ऑफ 398, सो दे हैव started or implementing the laws to put these corruptions down. And because of these, some historians and intellectual members, they have denied such practices. And society has criticized these classical worlds, जो भी इनके free features थे bureaucrats को, इन्होंने अपने writings में इसको show किया हुआ है. So the Roman states was an authoritarian regime. फिर from the very beginning हम देख रहे हैं कि वो authoritarian regime है. ठीक है ना. So these type of behaviors was untolerated and the government has responded to protect the violence. तो इसको बचाने के लिए government ने जो rulers हैं उन्होंने violence को protect करने के लिए they have specially taken the laws. So the Roman laws had emerged by the 4th century. 4 centuries में Roman laws बनना शुरू हो गया. ठीक है. So इससे क्या हुआ, तो this acted as a brake on even the most fearsome emperors. So जो rulers जो अपने आप में कुछ unfairly जो work कर रहे थे उनको भी criticized किया गया और उनको भी laws के under में लाया गया. So emperors were not free to do whatever they liked. So emperors were also told to follow the rules. And this is how the civil rights or civil actions were actively worked in the late antiquate periods. So that is why in the late as 4th century it was possible for powerful bishops like Ambrose to confine equal powerful emperors when they were extensively harsh or repressive in their handling of the civilian population. ठीक है ना. तो ये बहुत embraced है, लिखा हुआ है कि कुछ powerful rulers को भी control करने के लिए ये laws बहुत काम आए थे. especially for handling the civilian populations. So this was a chapter, and even you can see from the source here that what was the income of the Roman aristocracies around the 5th century. So this is giving the source. This source is giving us the correct informations that really the Roman aristocracies were controlled through their incomes. So this is the second last point or topic from the chapter 3. So I hope you understood, and please make the notes and frame as much as 1 mark questions. Thank you and have a nice day.